The organizational abilities in Final Cut Pro is one of my favorite things about the editing software, and it is a big reason why I think it is the most efficient editing software in the market. Welcome back to another MotionVFX Academy lesson. Let's get started.
Final Cut makes it easy for you to organize media. As we've learned, media is contained within an event that is in a library. In this movie, we'll learn how we can create additional events, view our clips in both list and film strip view, group clips, and organize them by rating them and creating keyword and smart collections. Now, currently I have a bunch of clips I've imported into one event that I've renamed Day One. But since they come from 2 days worth of shooting, I'll break them up by creating an additional event. This is easily done by going to the File menu and choosing New Event. You'll notice that the only library I have open right now is the Organize library, which it targets. And I'll give this event a different name called Day 2. I'm not going to create a new project, which is the discussion for the next movie, and choose to press OK. By default, this event is empty because we haven't imported any media into it. But we can head to our Day 1 event and then select the clips that we want to bring inside. I know that all of the night shots are what was filmed on Day 2, so I'll select the first one and then shift-click the group of them, and then simply just drag them into the Day 2 event. You'll notice that Day 1 has less clips, and Day 2 now contains all of the clips that I brought within it. If we need to see all of the media, we can easily go up to the Organize library, and both of our events, Day 1 and Day 2, are displayed. Currently, our clips are being displayed as thumbnails, which is known as film strip view. And we can actually change the appearance of this view by heading to the Clip Appearance menu. It's located at the top of the browser, and we can drag the slider next to the stopwatch icon to have a film strip represent a certain period of time. I'll set this to 2 seconds and then close the Clip Appearance menu. And if we take a look at clip 341642, from here to here, this black line represents 2 seconds, and so on and so forth for each of our clips to give us a rough representation of time. Now, besides film strip view, we also have list view. This can be enabled to the left of the clip appearance icon by toggling the display. And now we can see various columns of information such as the media duration and the content created. If you click on a specific column, it will organize clips in both ascending and descending order. You can also right-click a column to add additional columns to display more information associated with your clip. I'm going to click out of here. And another thing to mention is that our clips can also be grouped. I'm going to click on the list icon to toggle back on film strip view. And if we head once again to the clip appearance menu, you'll notice options for grouping as well as sorting our clips by different information. If I choose to group my clips by duration and then close the clip appearance menu, if I head to the top of my project, I'll see various clips that are 10 to 30 seconds, the longer ones. Now, so far we've just touched the surface of sorting and viewing our media, but we can organize our clips even further. One way is to create favorites by rating them. We can rate a clip or a portion of a clip as a favorite or reject a clip. Scrolling up to the very top of my project, one way to mark a clip as a favorite is to select the clip that you intend to rate. And if you head to the Mark menu, you can choose Favorite or press the F key. You'll notice that there's a green line on top of this clip, and you can in fact see it in a Smart Collection. If we click on the disclosure next to Smart Collections for our library and then click on Favorites, you'll see this is the clip that we just marked as a favorite. Let me select the Organize library again and scroll down in the project where we don't need this specific shot. I'll select it, and to reject that clip, I'm going to press Delete. Now, by default, clips that you rate as rejected will be hidden from view. This can be seen at the top right of the browser with the clip filtering set to hide rejected. And if we needed to see our rejected clips, we could either choose all clips or just identify our rejected ones. Here we'll notice that there's a red line on top of that clip that I've just pressed delete to. If we need to remove it from Final Cut entirely, we could select that clip and now press Command Delete. We get a warning dialog box saying that we're moving this media to the trash. I'll press OK knowing that I'm doing this, and then from my filtering menu, choose to hide rejected clips once again. Another way to organize clips are keyword collections. Now we can think of them as versatile folders that exist within an event contained within your library. Now one way to create one is to select a clip like this romantic reflection, and then click on the key icon on the top left of the interface. Here I'll add the word reflection, and once I press return, the keyword is now added to the clip, which we can see identified by the blue line on top of it. Now this keyword collection will show up in whatever event this clip belongs to, which happens to be day one. Click the disclosure triangle next to day one. We now see that reflection keyword collection. I'll select the organized library once again. We can easily add additional clips to this keyword collection by selecting them in the browser. I'll click and command click the remaining reflection shots and then just drag them onto the keyword collection in the sidebar. If we select that reflection keyword collection once again, we can see that now four clips are populated within it. Let me select that organized library once again. Another way to create a keyword collection would be to target the event that you wish to have the keyword collection, and then choose File, New, Keyword Collection, to which I'll rename Sparkles. Then I'll head back to my Day 2 event, and I'll find all the clips with sparkles that I can see that I'll now drag to the sidebar to add to that keywords collection. Now, on top of keyword collections and ratings, we also have smart collections. Now, smart collections are based on your clip properties. By default, in your Final Cut library, you get a smart collection folder, which will identify all of your video clips, audio-only assets, favorites, projects, and stills that you import into Final Cut Pro. We can also create additional library and event smart collections. For this example of creating a smart collection, I would like to be able to identify any missing media that could appear in my Final Cut project. Since I don't have any, I'm going to right-click a clip to reveal it in the Finder, and then right-click this again to move this in the trash. Heading back into Final Cut, I can now see that there's a missing file icon since Final Cut is no longer linking to that footage. I'll go to the Organize library and click on this magnifying glass in order to perform a search for the word missing. You'll see here that the missing file now shows up. From this, we can actually search for a combination of criteria by clicking on the icon next to the search field. And you'll notice that based on this search, we can create a new library smart collection. I'll click on that icon, to which we see it's set to untitled until we give it a new name. And now our missing file has been isolated into that smart collection. Let's review all of this information. I want to select the organized library. We can easily sort, sift, and organize media with ease. We can create additional events to place media into by going to the File menu and simply choosing New Event. We also have the ability to switch between our default film strip view that we're currently looking at and toggling List view to display columns of information that are associated with our clip. In addition to this, under the Clip Appearance menu, we can choose to group our clips by certain criteria, such as the duration. Heading back to Film Strip view, we can easily organize clips by rating them, such as pressing the F key to mark a clip as a favorite, or rejecting them by clicking on Delete. We then have keyword collections that we can create at any time by selecting a clip or a portion of the clip and clicking on this key icon and identifying a name. On top of this, we also have default smart collections that come with a library and are also available to us to create at any time when we perform searches, as well as add additional search criteria.